Hello everyone, this is Sumit Kumar, and again this question I'm going to do is related to ring theory. Everyone is not comfortable in ring theory. I don't know why, what is the exact reason, but trust me, it is one of the interesting topic and very interesting subject. In long run, it's very very important if you're going to make your career in algebra, particularly in algebraic geometry or algebraic number theory and number theory. All those parts, these are some like basic stuff you should know, particularly characteristic rings and all that, this kind of stuff you have to know, right? So let me see, what is the question? So this question is actually asked in this NET June, and this is the question number 87 in booklet code A. This is the question number 80 in booklet code B. This is the question number 80 in booklet code C. So every booklet code I have mentioned here, so this is the question. Let's try to understand and try to learn what are the concepts involved in it and get the ideas, right? So here's the question. Question is, let R be a non-zero ring with identity such that A square equal to A, right? Okay. And for all A belongs to R, which of the following is are true? So on that given information, which of the following are correct? First one, there is no such ring, first option. 2 times A equal to 0 for all A belongs to R, 3 times A equal to 0 for all A belongs to R, and fourth, Z by 2Z is a subring of R. See, how one can do this kind of questions, you know, where you have no information about the ring, just they have given you the 3 things. R is non-zero ring with identity element such that A square equal to A, right, that's what they have given, A square equal to A, and then they are asking an identity element. Then they are asking everything. What are the answer about it? So you know, there is a. So let me draw this on the conclusion from here. So how one can approach these kind of questions? That's important, right? So I always start how to think. How one can approach? What will be our approach? How one can go through these kind of questions and all. See, what is given? Given is, you have given me A square equal to A, and R is non-zero ring, and there exists unity element on R. That's what you have given. R is non-zero ring means R is non-trivial, and there exists a unity element. Unity element of, there is a multiplicative identity element. Then, on that info, since A square equal to A you have given, so from that, let me see this. That means A plus A cast bar is also equal to A plus M for all A belongs to this. Why I am going to do this? I will tell you later. Now apply A plus B ka whole square, A square plus B square plus AB plus 2AB, right? So using that information, this is 2A is equal to A plus A. Now A square equal to A, A square equal to A implies 2A equal to 0 for all A belongs to R. Therefore, char of R is equal to 2. Char of R is never going to be 1. Why? If char of R equal to 1, that means 1 times AR is equal to 0 for all R belongs to R. That means R is trivial ring, but R is non-zero ring. So, 2 times A must be 0 and not fewer than any elements. So, char of R is going to be 2. We are done, finished, right? Now, recall one theorem. Recall that theorem. Theorem says if char of R is equal to M, if char of R is equal to M and R is a ring with this property, non-zero and unity element belongs to this, then Z by MZ is a subring of R. This is a theorem. It's easy exercise to do this. Trust me, it is very easy exercise. This is a ring theoretical approach, you know. See, you can't expect me to that I should prove and all that. You have to do. If you need guidance, look at there. I have written something. Think about it and choose in proper way where you want to study. Okay? It's a really a big issue where you want to learn. So think about it. So this thing you will expect me to do here, it will take time. But I'll give you outline how to do this, right? So outline is very simple. give a homomorphism, ring homomorphism from Z to your this ring, let's say M times 1, where yes, your 1 is nothing but this M belongs to Z, right? And this is of course a subring of your R. R is a ring which carries M, and now this is a subring of R. What I have done, I have added 1 M times and looking on those collection. So this is a subring of R, and I am looking a map from Z to this subring. Clearly this is phi is onto ring homomorphism. And what is this map? This map is nothing but M tends to M times 1. So why every integer I am sending to M times 1, and M times 1 makes sense in R because R has unity, right? R has identity. So if you add 1 M times, you will get this. So I am sending M to M times 1. So this is a onto ring homomorphism. So let's call it, this is nothing but S. So this is a onto ring homomorphism from Z onto S. So by fundamental theorem, so by fundamental isomorphism theorem, what is this? So using that fundamental isomorphism theorem, Z by kernel of phi is isomorphic to R. But precisely your kernel of phi is nothing but multiple of M. That's nothing but M times Z. Therefore, Z by MZ is isomorphic to S, and S is a subring of R, and S is a subring of R. That implies you can view Z by MZ as a subring of R. So Z by MZ is a subring of R. So here, so care of that ring was 2. That's why we have done this. Now here, care of R is 2. So use this concept. So here, care of your ring is 2. Therefore, Z by 2Z, you can think this is a subring of R. Right? So Z by 2Z, you can think this is a subring of R. See, this is a notation for subring, not subgroup, okay? So Z by 2Z is a subring of R, so we are done, right? So this option is true. 2 times equal to 0. 3 times equal to 0? No. For that you can look, take R equal to this Z2. Z2 will be what? See, every element is satisfying your hypothesis, and if you multiply 3 times 1, you will get 1 which is not equal to 0 in Z2. So this is false. There is no such ring as false. There is always a such ring, Z2. So first try to look the examples, right? Do you have such example? Do I have ring? Yes, of course I have, Z2. That's what I have proved. Care of that ring must be 2. So look at those ring which has care 2 and apply your concept, okay? So I hope you got the idea, right? Yes. Thank you for watching. Go through the basics of ring theory. If you really want to confront in ring theory, and what do you mean by something like a square equal to a? What do you mean by z by 2z is a subring of, and all these are some basic concepts. This will come again and again. Forget that you are going to write in net, gate, and HM, all that. Learn for your benefit, right? If you learn, you will be confident, your confidence will grow, and you will feel very comfortable in any exam. Not in this net, gate, and all that. In any exam in your life related to mathematics, you will feel very comfortable if you study in a good manner, where you can understand each concept in proper way and feel happy, okay? So do mathematics as much as you can, and one day I will see you soon, okay? Thank you for watching my videos, and best